So it's fair to say that Pep Guardiola's first year in charge was not as successful as many would have assumed. So therefore, they will approach that issue with the same way they approach everything, with big old bags of cash. You get some cash.
Yeah, you based on cash. Some of the names that are signing right now, I think I might be worth like £10 million. That's not bad. That's like 25% of what Monaco dude signed for. £2 million? That's a
$2.
$2.
$2. It's probably like a buy one, get one free sort of thing. We get both of us.
$2.
Two for one.
God, yeah, it's so like a salary here.
Carrying on our successful segment, and by successful, I have no means to gauge that. I just mean that we want to do it. So let's take a look at the Man City players that's already left. Courtesy of Jason Rubin's great card.
So intern.
There's somewhat of a exodus going on, and it's a good exodus for Manchester City fans because it signifies a moving away from some of the kind of classic players. Like for instance, they're definitely looking for fullbacks this year because when you get rid of Zabaleta, who's held that position down for a while, alongside Alexis Sagna, who's came in, and Gael Clichy. These are former Arsenal players, and those two that have came and won trophies, done a job, and now they're getting on a bit, so they're probably going to have to leave. Jesus Navas, I've never been a huge fan of him. I think he's all bark, no bite. I think he doesn't have the final product enough times. He's useful in certain games, but he's just not as effective for how much possession they would give him of the ball when he's on the park, but he's got a good engine on him, so he'll find a club somewhere else. And then Caballero, goalkeeper, and some other players in there that I don't really care about.
Zabaleta's been around.
Zabaleta's been around. He's been a fantastic servant. Like, he's not going to be the one
that players I don't care about.
He's not going to be one that they're going to be like, oh, so bad to lose him. Or he's not going to be one that's going to be like, see you later, don't let the, like, when what's his name left?
It's not enough to win you a trophy, but I have to get you relegated.
Well, he did. That's the thing. He won trophies when he was there in a time where today, he fit today. The mold. But now it's Pep Guardiola, and look at the fullbacks that Pep Guardiola's had in the past: David Alaba, Philip Lahm, Dani Alves, Jordi Alba. These are not.
Everybody has to have Alba.
Yeah, you have to sign an Alba.
Alba or Alves.
If he could, he would sign an Alba. Don't get me wrong, he would do that in a second. But that's somewhat unrealistic. So.
But they've made some moves.
They've made some moves. Monaco are cha-ching.
Oh my God. Cha-ching. That's the club. If I could buy into any club right now, it'd be Monaco.
But from an investment standpoint?
Yeah, investment standpoint. Besides, you can gamble in Monaco.
Yeah, it's a good place. It's like apparently it's a tax haven as well.
Look at that. That's perfect. All right, so the next card we have is the. There's been three already signed, I believe, or maybe two. One of which is from Monaco, and then lastly, there's also the targets. I mean, and to be fair, everyone's a good target in the case if you're Manchester City. So element number two, and we'll throw to that one. There it is. So two players, Silva and
Moraes.
Moraes, thank you.
Moraes, the goalkeeper from Benfica, very highly touted. He goes by Ederson. I think I may be completely wrong, but
well, he has to. It's his first name, so at some point he probably does go by Ederson.
But it signifies like the goalkeeper point of position is one that it's still not secure, so that's a big signing to bring in because Claudio Bravo had a very iffy time
after all the shite they gave Joe Hart for Claudio Bravo to play the way he did. I'm happy Joe Hart went elsewhere. Mm-hmm. Like he was like chased out of the city. Granted, he didn't look so great for England this weekend. He looked good except from the free kick range.
He doesn't move his feet fast enough. That's my thing with Joe Hart. He's a good goalkeeper. He's a great shot stopper, but he's always getting beat on free kicks. He doesn't move his feet quick enough to get across the line.
Some guys just don't have it.
Sometimes I even think, like, it's just a completely weird off the cuff analogy. Sometimes I think when you've got a free kick against you from like 30 out. Just get the wall out of the way. Don't even have a wall. Just stand in the middle of your goal and go, have at it.
Move it around the way. Are you kidding me?
Ping it and see where it goes.
I think that's what we should be doing with penalty kicks from day one.
Sometimes I think the wall just is
35 yards.
Yeah. If it's like right in the edge of the box, and of course, like you're not going to be able to get to one end of your goal or the other. But I'm talking about when it's like 35 out, you've got enough time, I think, to gauge where that ball's going to go.
You've seen my free kick? You've seen it once, and it was glorious. What do you think about a £40 million Kyle Walker transfer from Tottenham? Mm-hmm. That just seems like a lot of money for a guy in the Premier League. Is he gonna make that big? Other question. Does it even matter what the price is if you're Manchester City or Manchester United?
No.
Because like if you can just buy everybody that you want and it's gonna cost you more, it's not like there seems to be some disadvantage or some penalty if you, whatever, we'll give Kyle Walker £80 million. Who cares? We have the money. We can sign other players too for $80 million if we want. But is Kyle Walker the right person? He just doesn't strike me. I don't know enough about the guy. He just doesn't strike me as a significant, and it's not just name, but just his impact. Manchester City is not that far away with the squad they have from winning trophies.
But what about the squad that's ahead of them? The squad that finished second?
Tottenham.
And that's a fullback. And there's two of them, Danny Rose and Kyle Walker.
Logically, that makes sense. Why would he leave Tottenham?
Well, that's another question.
Money.
No, there's another question. Why would he leave Tottenham? I would like for him to stay. I rate Kyle Walker. I rate Danny Rose. I rate the fullback.
Was he one of the all plays into Premier League 11 guys, Kyle Walker?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, well, and what do I know?
He's a good fullback. It just depends. It's different playing under a Tottenham style play where they don't want you to move the ball around from the back as much. He would be asked to be in possession a lot more if he played with Manchester City. Whether that would favor him or not, who knows? He's a good fullback. He's a strong fullback, and he's defensively sound. But
you don't sound, you're just, how you're explaining him is, you don't sound sold. You don't sound excited for Manchester City.
I don't know if that's,
you're one of their eight fans.
I don't know if it's what they need essentially to bring in. I think they need a center back. I don't think that Stones has got the capabilities to lead this back line by himself.
Do it.
Company, Otamendi.
So what about Bonucci on the target list?
Of course. Everyone should be going after Bonucci, but it's a thing about whether Bonucci wants to go. Again,
the clip is they have to sign these players to win the Premier League. So if they were to sign Bonucci, would that be enough?
If they sign Bonucci and they sign Kyle Walker, that's two amazing steps to winning the Premier League. Yes,
and you need maybe to competing in the Champions.
Maybe. The Premier League, you don't need a great squad to win it. We've had that proven by Leicester City. You just need a good, consistent team.
It's legendary.
To build it, yeah, it's a legendary squad, but
in my book,
it couldn't have been that good if it crumbled with the departure of one player, meaning that one player was very much
so
crucial. So I don't know, man. This Manchester City are so bipolar. They're just a strange team. Like, we look at when Gundogan was playing and he wasn't injured, you're like, okay, that's a great signing. But when he was injured once again, I don't know if it was a detriment to the whole team. Like, it was a big hole there. When Aguero's on form, he's the best striker in the league. But when he's out of form, they don't have enough up top. When Kevin De Bruyne's in form, he's one of the best players in the league. It's just a consistency thing with Manchester City. And that's something that Pep Guardiola usually has down to a T, is consistency. Yes, it was his first season. So if I was him, it's not as much these players, it's these positions. You need a center back. You need a right back. Do you need a left back? I don't like Kolarov. He's still very easily beat, and he's not quick enough.
They have the goal scoring power. It's not like they need problem scoring goals.
The attacking third, you don't need to worry about that much, because Gabriel Jesus is going to probably have a more prolific role this season if they use him a lot more. He's a young, talented player, and he's got the guidance of Sergio Aguero, a player that's almost molded and exact same as him. Play very similar.
Don't you think Aguero's leaving, is there? That would be a groundbreaking transfer.
Maybe next season, who knows?
Also, Francis, sometimes it just helps to start your own rumors.
Is that what they've been doing?
That's what they've been doing. According to Manchester City's Twitter account, some people have called them out for, I guess, starting their own rumors. Reports claim Manchester City, which is them, are monitoring a three-time Champions League winner. Man City now running their own transfer rumors.
I guess that's one way.
You are Manchester City.
That's one way to cause like some problem amongst the camp. It's just like, because when you're Man City, you have the weight of the money behind you. So you just be like, rumor has it, trying to get Jason Rubin away from TYT Sports. Would that unsettle you?
You'd be like, if I was playing for Manchester City?
If they just wanted to sign you for Manchester City TV?
Not for $2. According, that's money. My value, according to Francis Maxwell, so no.
My
clause is more expensive.
It's like $3. I don't think it's just Man City. We proved this earlier on. What did you type in the other day? Lionel Messi transfer rumors, and it just came up a full
list. Yeah, but it would be different if Barcelona was sending out from their official Twitter account, hey, rumors on Manchester City, Lionel Messi's transfer. You'd be like, well, hold on. First of all, if that happened, it would be trending because
we'd be talking about it right now.
Hey, recently, as our intern did tweet out recently, Ronaldo, it was like to the date, like 2 days ago, that 2009 that Real Madrid bought Ronaldo from Manchester
United.
In what you can call a landscape changing.
88, I believe, was it at that point? 88 million?
88,000 goals scored, correct. in the probably the most landscaping changing in retrospect transfer of the last decade.
Yeah, absolutely.
If Ronaldo stayed at Manchester United, they probably would have maybe a Champions League or two.
They had one before he left, and I think they would have added several more.
Yeah, I don't think anybody would touch him in the Premier League.
No, I think they would have went on to be. I mean, you've got that polarizing a figure you just continuously add. Probably Sir Alex would still be there. He'd be like, I don't need to chuck it. We're going to be
How
very
old is
good.
He now?
He's like 78.
Do you make that up?
Or just no, I think he's around his late 70s. Hmm. He's not exactly a young lad, and Ronaldo still calls him boss, as we've seen after the Champions League final. Like, hey boss, how are you?
He's a sir.
Ronaldo, great player.
Can't say
he's ours.
Oh, Ronaldo.
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 All right, what do you think about Manchester City? What do they have to do? It was a very hard question to answer. Jesus just likes to throw the hardest questions because
more fun.
The thing is it's we don't know who they need to bring the Premier League because it's changed.
Bonucci.
Bonucci would be a monumental step. Probably should be the number one on the transfer list.
Why don't I run Manchester City? I don't get this. Not that hard. Hey,
do you have the oil money?
Come hang out with us. Do you have oil money?
If Buffon retired, maybe Bonucci would go.
Money. Kidding.
If Buffon retired, maybe Bonucci would be more willing to leave. But Buffon ain't going anywhere.
Seriously?
He's staying for another year.
Good for Buffon.
He's giving another shot.
Yeah, he's not. Now he might just be chasing.
He's chasing, champion.
He's chasing.
He's chasing.
It's gonna be tough to get back there.